Five, four, three, two, one, go!
Don't you dare mock me or any of our colleagues. I'm more than willing to persecute you with one more blab out of your mouth. You are such a dewdropper. Rapidus, you have yet to finish, so soiree will commence in a few hours.
Attaboy, there she goes again, commencing the interrogations of say you do not realize that we have our matter in mind. Are you half cut with the misery of your soul working as a maid?
Oh, come on, quit your nonsense and get back to work and quit your giggle water. Behavior. Hurry now, everyone places, shall we? And we'll complete this task.
Alright. Your dull love of mine does not pay us enough to argue with such undiplomatic comments. And now, if you would please get off my back, Gladys, or please scram.
Greetings, everyone. Are you folks entirely set to monitor your eggselves out on the dance floor? Well, by my word, I hope of all you being such. Isn't that right, my wife and first lady?
Of course.
Now, before all commence to gather on your stepping feet intact with one another, I would like to state of my son's virginal being. Now, all you singular ladies out there, grab hold of yourselves because my son Romeo is in search of a wife. Woo-hoo! Yes, ladies, you all advocated me correctly.
Didn't have to diminish that fact. Here, in spite, our son is still in the dumps of his former God rested love Annie. Please have some respect toward his dwelling of life. This festive experience was up to have his mind off of that subject of women. Please. How you dare! You bring the topic of women once again up in his face.
Oh, Loretta, this rub is to have our son enjoy himself with the company of other pretty ladies that may become his future wife. Anywho, I beg your pardon of execution. However, I plan this as a tribute for my son's well-being.
All right, oh mighty God, I am never able to argue with you. You always take the obscurance out of nonsense and approach it as well needed.
Ha ha, I need it. Indeed, you know me well, wife. For that matter is why I married you and not one other mistress. With no good thought of one's field, now shall my pretty lady and I dance the evening away into soul darkness.
Who is that young man across the dance floor? Darling, I'm Rufio Liam. Oh, he says perfect as Dracula's.
Oh, that young man is Romeo, the son of the six curious of this soiree. He is a handsome one, isn't he, madam?
Oh, he is the most perfect man of time. The manner for which he executes himself drives me out of my pants. I must be crackers over him. Also gladly of taking the hand of Jane and letting her drag me to this blow.
I wouldn't have found my perfect match. So gladly I'd like to go over and introduce myself. Also, the sweet majesty of creation doesn't deserve a feat of myself, especially of I not pertaining to this party. Oh, don't pick any wooden nickels. For God, if at reach of your fingertips, no such pheasants to invoke my presence with this fine.
Whom is that maiden standing beside, glimmering over the drinking area? She's not but a rival, I sense it. It's nothing but a fish, I tell you. Of opposing Montague's sector, I rise to you. Capulet? Listen! For why may we allow such prayers at our... Dear me! Aren't you listening? Or are you as opposed to your archers as you seem to be at these moments in time?
Well, miss, why such hot respondents to a patriot of our festivities? Calm your kisser, for she is a child. Don't be a nudnik.
If you allow for such an unwanted guest to remain, why in the world did you not invite every other Montague? For that case being so, you wouldn't have treated them all, I suppose.
For the sake of Romeo, let her be, my goodness. Have you not considered anyone else's emotions besides yourself? Everyone believe of us if we toss all out only because of one's Romeo and Juliet, whom, as far as what I've heard, only acquires traits of wellness. That of we being obscure, ha, that shall not pass upon my reputation.
Why? What will everyone think if you do not?
Everyone will know that of us in labeling good deeds. Now, if you would only allow for myself to get back to roaming with my wife.
Fine. How, instance, for only because I am of your disposal. However, the second I witness rage on this scene, I shall do but less than nothing to stop it because you're invoked.
I would surely say that you being a marvelous gentleman who is just diplomatic from being, I do indeed crave you faster than upon me. Baby, see this year, she can be invited in this year. If you don't mind the pleasure shrine, to his own mind.
For maiden, what sin is this? I cannot take manners of this. Partnership with you. Although you are very pretty, is this rejoicing of sin? Would it be praise without marriage? I wish to apologize. The shrine for which you exhibit makes me appreciate your optimism and your love even more.
Partners for how we express our emotions, of thought, why may we utilize them for matters of love and relationship.
And oh, but the manner for which I speak is so forth to my faith and believing no signage. I'm not a bird to you, am I?
You are perfect and love is the union for religion retrospectively, and as you may see, I carry quite a part for you.
However, for how may we embrace with none but any pastor of marriage? I wish not to say that the bank's closed.
Oh, come on, Mr. Pastor. The cash winner, and I did too love my paddock. Do you pass your check to me by then?
How would I not dare to accept a young a beauty as you? Shall we omit once again? Or with you I'm better. I just wanna see you
smile. My gosh, your breaks like the heavens reach from God, so substantial.
Romeo, sweet gentleman, your mother is in search of you.
Excuse me, who is his mother?
Well, she is Madame Loretta, the prominent figure of this house, and welly embellished lady of folk. I grew Romeo, for he is as my own son, a young virtue indeed.
Oh my, is he a Capulet? My goodness, what a man I have chosen as the love for my life. What a virtue I have broken, indeed with this risk I have broken.
Come on, dear cousin. The plague of fight between our houses is at depth. Let's flee now.
More than fleeing, what cause but none of an outbreak to persist, and my love put to rest.
Whoa, whoa, ladies. Have you gotten to be gone now? Well, if you choose, thank you indeed for accompanying us in the dear festivity. I appreciate it greatly, and for all I know, my young Romeo is at a great admirer in this one night, and I pleasurably admire your content at this night.
Level with me, nurse. Who was that doll who wrinkled right out of here?
That young woman was Juliet, the daughter of Eleanor Montague, son.
Says you? How may that be so?
Why, she is not swell. She is your enemy, for why the concern, son?
Oh my, I respond being, no problem. Do I have about that?
Well, are you such a sap to think about that kind of a person, your enemy?
Nurse, I was just curious. Is it so wrong to be mindful over a being?
Then I just believe that of you having other intentions with that such rival and opponent, lady. However, I am glad of your curiosity toward life and people.
I would really appreciate if you were to leave me a solitary. Get a wiggle on, please. I'm exhausted from all the jazz tonight.
All right. I'm glad you have your mind off that other lady. Well, I shall leave you to rest till tomorrow, son.
Yes, forgotten of her, but empired over Juliet, my so-called rival. But how? May Lord forgive me. However, love is no entity on its own, but a masterpiece of temptation. How have I fallen for a maiden of act with opposing threats?
Everybody needs inspiration.
To that of my just now? Did the Lord have to punish me twice in a row at the spot of enticement over search? Oh, now may this punishment be solved. Just how God, my love and only half, is my arch enemy? But why this punishment to me?
We were both young when I first saw you. I close my eyes and the flashback starts. I'm standing there on a balcony in summer air. See the lights, see the party, the ball gowns. See you make your way through the crowd and say hello. Little did I know,
Romeo loved Juliet. Juliet, she felt the same. When he put his arms around her, he said, Julie, baby, you're my flame. Thou givest fever.
For she is such a child, don't be a good
man. Uncle, this peasant is the Montague, rear end of society. Don't act upon of the end? But she is a pill. We need to pinch her along with any of the others alike together. In
there?
Whoa.
You should just go, it's not been a whoa, whoa. And then you go, whoa, whoa, lady, and I'm just like,
No, we'll just crop it out.
No,
yeah, we'll crop it out.
No, you have to place and then you walk 22.
Oh no,
Just walk.
No. Walk. Just walk.
Yeah.
Romeo, sweet gentleman, your mother is in search of you.
You can see this. Oh, Lori came out.
Did you see it?
Ah, 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 ah.
I've been watching you, every little thing you do. Every time I see you dance, my homeroom class makes my heart beat fast. I've tried to paint you twice, but I see you roll your eyes. Wish I could make it real, but your lips are sealed, that ain't no big deal. Cause I know you really want me, I hear you threaten something about me. So why are you trying to do without me, when you got me, when you want me? You're fine, you really blow my mind. Maybe someday you'll make you run away. I just want you to know I wanna be your Romeo. Hey Juliet, hey Juliet, hey Juliet. Really got me on my knees, begging, please, baby, please. Got my best DJ on the radio, waiting.
Yeah, what are you doing?
Too far to turn around. Someone stand my ground. Give me just a little bit of hope, a smile or a glance. Give me one more chance. Cause I know you really want me. I hear you learn something about me. So why are you trying to do without me? When you got me, when you want me,
Juliet.